Okay, so most of the cakes I make are cute or pretty, you know, weddings. But today we're making something pretty gross. We made an acne covered cake. Perfect for your welcome to puberty or happy 13th birthday, maybe. But these are actually poppable. Ooh, they're actually poppable. And we're gonna pop some of these after I show you how I made it. Would you eat this cake? Would you? I don't know if I would. I don't know if I could. So gross. Okay, to start our little gross creation here, I've got some fondant to match the fondant here. It's like a fleshy tone. I've got a bowl of water, and I made this little concoction of powdered sugar and vegetable oil. A little bit sweet. You could also use just buttercream. But I chose not to do that just because this tends to be more oily looking, like the consistency that I want. And I use the oil instead of like powdered sugar and water because the water will melt the fondant. So to start, I'm just gonna tear off a little piece of the fondant and roll it and sort of flatten it out and make a cup on my fingertip. Like so. And I'm just gonna take a little bit of my oily goo and place it inside like that. It's already gross. It's already gross. Okay. And then I'm just gonna dip a paintbrush into some water and wet the edge. That. And then I'm just going to find a place to attach it to the cake. Pressing it down to seal the edges first. And then I'm just going to pull out the edges so that they sort of disappear. I'm just thinning it out. Sometimes it helps to use the side of a tool to sort of scrape it to get it to blend better. You could also dab on a little bit of water that helps melt the fondant . So there's one for now. Okay, so we're going to make a different kind, and I'm going to use organic cocoa butter. It comes in these little chips like this. And I thought they'd be great because I think it's like the perfect color and consistency for those blemishes that have the more pellet-like things that pop out. It's getting really gross. So I just broke up a little piece of that. I'm gonna make this one smaller. So I just take a little smaller piece of fondant, do the same thing. Flatten it out and put a little bit of my goo in there. And then put one of my pellets inside. Hopefully this will work. And we're gonna do the same process, sticking it on with water. All right, so for a different type, I have these black sprinkles that are in this Halloween mixture. So I thought I'd make a blackhead, or at least attempt to make a blackhead, so. I'm gonna take, why not use one of these, a little sprinkle. Whoop. For this one, I'm just gonna put a little bit of the goo. Again, we're gonna attach it, but I think what might work is if I push the sprinkle in from the outside. So I think what needs to be done is then I need to sort of, I have a pin. I'm gonna poke a little hole in there so that I can insert blackhead in. That's so gross. One last thing I wanna try is I got this blood red glaze. It's from Wilton. And I thought maybe if I put some of this mixed in with the goo, we can get some like bloody seepage. So let's try that. Once again, let's flatten it out. A little goo inside. You don't want to get the goo close to the edge because then it makes it harder to stick. And then what if we squeeze a little of this in it? The drop. Now I'm going to put a lot more around the cake, but before I do that, I just want to paint some of it. Then I'm going to take some gel color. We've got some white, some golden yellow, and some brown mixed together to make sort of an ivory color, like a very slightly off-white color. Okay, and then I'm just going to paint for the next step. I really wasn't sure. I'm really not sure what's going to work better, using petal dust or gel color. But I've got some gel color that I've just diluted with some vodka. You can use extract. I'm going to redden it up a little bit. You just lay in the reddest part around, and then have some clear vodka available to sort of clean your brush out on so that you could blend the color outwards so that it just fades out. Now, I don't think blackheads tend to be quite as angry for whatever reason, so I'm not going to make that super red. All right, I'm going to keep adding more around and I will show you. Show you when I'm all done. Okay, so I did a test where I squeezed this one and I didn't get that gooey effect that I wanted. So I thought maybe it didn't have enough of the goo in it in the first place. So I have decided to try a different thing. So I'm just gonna poke this upper one with a pin. And then I put some of the goo into a parchment bag. And I'm just gonna pipe some extra of the filling in there. Ugh, it looks so gross already. To just sort of make sure it is stuffed. And this one I want to be a blackhead, so I'm going to poke that one, fill it with some more goo to where it's practically bursting, and then I'm going to put one of my black sprinkles in there. I think it actually looks better this way with a little bit of that filling poking out. Ugh. All right, hopefully this works better. Eat it.